Hi friends, how are you today? Still as busy as ever, chaotic as ever, so I think it's time again to take a pause, to calm down, to breathe. To breathe some more. To quieten our hearts and make space for our Father's voice. We're going to continue reading the scriptures where we left off yesterday. This time going to Genesis 1, verse 2. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. You know, I've always wondered why, when God created the world, He decided to make it look quite depressing, really. I mean, read the description, right? Formless, empty, dark, full of, I suppose, swirling waters. I mean, it's quite clear that this God is powerful. He can make something out of nothing. He brings into existence things that didn't previously exist. This God is the source of all life, and He could have so easily just snapped His divine fingers and created at once a beautiful heavenly city teeming with life, which is what He does in the last book of the Bible. So why then, when He first makes the earth, we're not really told about the heavens much, and not in Genesis anyway, but why when He makes the earth at first, is it this barren, shapeless mass of black water? Well, the verse gives us a clue, right? It says that there's another person called the Spirit of God. Literally, it says it's the breath of God. This second person, the breath spirit, seems to be hovering or fluttering over the face of these newly created dark swirling waters. One ancient translation even said the spirit was brooding over the waters. Reading this together, the language has given some ancient Christians that this idea that the world is like, almost like a womb, so to speak. An empty, barren, dark, full of water womb. And this spirit is like a bird, sort of like a mother, right? Hovering over this egg, getting ready for something, anticipating something. Something big is going to happen to this depressing, chaotic, sort of proto-world. Life is coming. What do we need to transform chaos world into beautiful garden city? That's what Genesis is asking us to anticipate, to think about, to long for. What do we need to transform the empty womb and fill it with life in abundance? Well, we have to wait. We wait patiently for the answer. So let's do that, shall we? Let's wait for God. God sends His Spirit, and the Spirit's always doing something, always. Something that will turn emptiness into fullness, chaos into order, death into life. Again, let's take a moment to talk to God about these things that we're reflecting on, and express our desire for His Spirit to do the same work in us, to bring life to us, those of us whom everything is changing, swirling, maybe even dying. Let's take a minute to be quiet. Father, we thank You that it was never Your plan to leave the world in darkness, in emptiness. Your Holy Spirit You sent to bring life. And we wait for this same Spirit. We wait for this same life. Amen. And again, why don't we take some time to sing privately to the Lord? A link to the song should be available in the description below this video.